Thanks so much for being here for this training today. No better time to be the hands and feet of Jesus. No better time to preach the gospel, not by words, but by our actions than right now. You know what? Together we're better. And we as a Lakewood family, we're committed for the long haul to help our city recover. God bless you and have a great day.
So obviously before you get started, you want to make sure that you're safe. You're going to need a mask for insulation, and you're going to take the bottom strap, put it over your head, take the top strap, put it over the back of your head above your ears, and then you're going to pinch the metal strip that's right here on top of your nose. Then we're going to start on teaching you guys how to install insulation, and then from there we'll talk about how to install sheetrock. And then lastly, how to tape, float, and mud. Insulation, first off, you're going to need a stapler, box cutter or utility knife, tape measure. This is how you install insulation. I know that's a mouthful, but... So you're going to just measure these inside cavities right here, the stud base. I've got right here, I've got 14 and a half by 11 and a half. Best way to cut insulation is obviously on a flat surface, preferably a board of some sort, but so I'm just going to press down at my 14 and a half inch mark, just like that. There we go. I'm going to cut this to 11 and a half. And you're just gonna push it right in there, just like that. And that's good. There's two types of insulation. Primarily there's unfaced, which this is what we're using here today. Now if you install unfaced insulation, you need to apply a vapor barrier. And what the vapor barrier does is it blocks any moisture that comes from the outside and wants to come inside the home. So your sheetrock goes here on top of this vapor barrier and prevents any moisture from sitting on that back of that sheetrock, which causes condensation, which in turn causes black mold. And you definitely don't want to do that. So the other type of insulation is called craft-faced. This is craft-faced insulation, and this is just basically the same idea. It's got a vapor barrier on the front of it. And these little tabs right here, you can actually use to staple against the studs so they'll stay nice and tight. So when installing unfaced insulation like what we have here we're installing today, you have to install the vapor barrier that I spoke about before. So I'm going to show you guys how to install the vapor barrier. It's very easy. Measure the height, which right we have about 14 and a half inches, okay? And I'm just going to measure this section of wall right here. I've got about 5 feet. All right, so I'm going to show you how to cut the vapor barrier, super easy. So I had a height of 14 and a half. I'm going to mark that right there. Mark it right here. Thank you, lovely assistant. Get out my box cutter knife. Use this as my straight edge. I'm going to line up the marks. And there you go. So we're going to take this over here. Now there's an outlet right here, and I'm going to show you how to very easily cut that out as well. So we're just going to fasten this section right here. I'm going to overlap it. Just by a few inches. I'm going to staple that. And what you can do right here for these outlets very easily, just mark the, you know, notice the area right there, and you're just going to make a little X. Obviously, be very careful when cutting this stuff. We've got a nice little
hole right there. Staple that down. And there you go. That takes care of the vapor barrier. Next thing we're gonna do is sheetrock. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys how to install a piece of sheetrock in this space right here. Really good thing to do before you get started is to make sure that all these studs right here, these are the studs, just make sure that there's no nails sticking out, just like you see these guys down there. Just go ahead and pound those in, or if there's screws, you're gonna wanna take those out. That's going to cause the sheetrock to not sit tight on the wall. It's going to create a bubble and stuff like that. So do all that first before you put the sheetrock in. So what I'm going to do is just measure this space. And the idea is a sheet of sheetrock is 8 feet long. These studs right here are every 16 inches on center, okay? So I'm going to measure this space and make sure that it lands on the center of a stud, and that's where the end of the sheetrock's going to go. So right here I have an 8-foot sheet landing right there, okay? I'm going to take my width. Got 16 inches right there, you can see. I'm gonna make it just a touch smaller so it fits, because we've got plenty of room. There's gonna be baseboard that goes along the floor that's gonna cover that space up, so make it just a little bit smaller than 16 inches, and we're going to show you how to cut the piece of sheetrock right now. Okay, so now that I've measured the sheetrock, or the area that the sheetrock's going in, I've made a mark down from the top edge. This is the factory edge, okay? We're going to go down 15 and 3 quarters on this side, and then we're going to go 15 and 3 quarters down on that side, and we are going to snap a line, okay? So I'm just going to line up the chalk line on those two marks. Then you're just going to gently pull the chalk line back and let it snap. And it creates a nice solid line so you can cut the sheetrock. So now, I'm going to, as best as I can, use my box cutter right here to cut on this line. Now what you want to do with sheetrock, this is a really quick and easy tip, is just going to cut this paper edge right here, okay? Very lightly, just enough to get the knife in just a little bit. And we're gonna follow that line. Let's see if I do a good job. Okay, we're gonna follow that line all the way through, okay? Just applying a little bit of pressure on that piece of sheetrock. All right, almost there. And there we go. Okay, so now that you've done that, you're going to pull the sheet away. All right, now watch this. This is where the magic happens, people. We're going to very lightly, right in the area of where that line was on the back side of the sheet, okay? I'm just going to put a little pressure on the top and push that way. At the same time, I'm going to keep my hand here and keep it stable and just snap the piece, okay? Now I've created a nice straight line back here, okay, to cut the piece of sheetrock away, all right? And you have to be very careful. Keep in mind that I've got my leg right here up against the sheet, okay? Just don't get this knife into your leg. Or, so here we go. Just very lightly, doesn't take a lot of pressure. All the while I'm holding the sheet. If you want to have somebody help you, like my lovely wife, or your lovely wife, gonna keep following that edge, lightly applying pressure until we get to the very end, okay? And now I'm going to just, the opposite way, take the sheet, and voila! You've got yourself a cut piece of sheetrock. We're gonna bring this over to the wall. So, now that we've cut our piece of sheetrock, we've got an outlet right here, a receptacle that we have to cut out, okay? And I'm gonna show you how to do that. So I'm putting my piece down there, right at that very edge, okay? Now I've got my outlet right here. I'm just gonna make a reference point where it is. That's the center of the outlet that I'm gonna be cutting out, okay? I'm gonna measure down from this edge where the sheetrock's going to sit down to the center of the receptacle box, which is 4.5. And we're gonna make a mark, okay? So now that's the center. And I'm gonna show you how to cut this out, either with a handsaw or a rotozip if you feel really adventurous.
Don't forget your safety glasses before you make this cut. I'm gonna use this handy dandy little sheetrock saw, okay? Very sharp, be careful. Act tongue. I've made my mark for the outlet, okay? Now, I'm going to just put the blade edge right there, all right? And if you're not comfortable using this tool, please talk to your team leader and they can help you out, or a licensed contractor that's well aware of how to use these tools. Okay, I'm just going to punch it through the sheet. Okay, now it's on the back side. I've got this started right here. Careful with these outlets, of course. You want to make sure that your power is turned off when handling these so you don't get electrocuted.
Okay. Right. Wait. Take it back. There
okay.
We go.
All right. Just not straight, so okay. I'm going to, we gotta relieve that edge right there so I can get the piece up a little higher. Process of the demo, if a line on the wall, it's on the sheetrock that's not snapped and it's not cut straight, there's a bit of process work to get the new piece of sheetrock to fit in the space. So as you can see, what I had to do is I just had to straighten out that line a little bit to get this piece of sheetrock in. So keep in mind, that's another thing that, you know, you may have to do in the process of the rebuild. So I'm marking out the studs. So you've got a stud that goes all the way up and you need that to secure the sheetrock to the wall with a screw. So I'm just making marks on the floor. And right here, this is where I'm gonna screw. So right there, and then I'm gonna end up screwing down here. So I'm just making marks to know where to screw. Next, we're gonna fasten the sheetrock to the wall. So I'll show you how to do that. You're gonna need two things in particular. This right here is a great tool. It's called a drywall screw gun. If you don't have that, you can use a cordless drill gun or a corded drill gun. The only thing with this is this actually sets the head of the screw properly into the sheetrock. And what you don't want to do is you don't want to sink these screws, these drywall screws, all the way through the sheetrock, because it will not hold the sheetrock to the wall and will end up falling away not too long afterwards. So Just keep that in mind. What I'm using to screw these on is a drywall screw right here. You can find these at any type of building supply store like Home Depot or Lowe's or your local hardware store. This is our screw gun right here, and as you can see, it's got a collar on it, and that's what stops the screw at a certain point. It's set for a depth right here. As you can see, there's different depths. So I'll show you how to do that right now. So we've marked our studs on the wall. Okay, this is our stud right here, and I've got a mark on the floor. So we're gonna fasten with two spots, because this is only a 2 foot section of sheetrock. All we're going to need is one screw right here and one screw right there. So carefully place your screw on the tip of the screwdriver, and I'm gonna, and as you can see right there how it's recessed? That's good, okay? If it's any deeper than that, then you have to back it out and redo it, okay, and put a different screw in. So I'm gonna go ahead and got my mark down there. And set a little bit more, and that's perfect right there. So we're gonna go ahead and put these screws in, all the rest of these studs down there, and this sheet right here will be fastened after that. We'll be good to go. After you've installed your sheetrock, we're going to show you how to tape and float. And right down here are some supplies that you're gonna need. First, you're gonna need a box cutter or a utility knife, okay? You're gonna need some tape. What I like to use preferably is mesh tape. This actually has an adhesive back to it, so it makes it really easy. It sticks right to the wall. You're going to need a 10-inch taping knife and a 5-inch or 6-inch taping knife. And then you're going to need a mud pan, and this is great. You're gonna end up putting the compound right in here. It's got a great little blade on both sides where you can clean off your knife just like that. And lastly, you're going to need some compound right here. And this is good stuff right here. So we're gonna get started. I'll show you how to tape and float. If this is your first time taping and floating, it's a good idea to put on some nitrile gloves. It's gonna get pretty messy, so. But we have our adhesive seam tape right here, and I'm gonna show you how to apply that. It's super easy. So we've got our seam right here, okay? We're gonna take our seam tape, and now I'm using this for instructional purposes right here, so. I'm gonna take our seam tape, you're gonna apply that right to the center, and just stick it right to the wall. And you keep going down. Make sure you cover all the seams, all the cracks, everything. Go ahead and be generous with it. You can overlap anywhere you need to overlap. Alright. Alright, so now that we have that on, just make sure it's stuck to the wall. We're gonna take our 6-inch taping knife. We've got our joint compound in the mud pan right now, okay? 6-inch taping knife. We're going to apply some mud right to the wall right now. So you want to be, just apply this in light measurement, light increments. You don't want to put too much on. It gets pretty gloppy. It gets messy. It takes forever to dry. So we're just going to put a nice light coat right here on the seam. Just work it into the corner, okay? I'm just going to get a nice light coat on there, okay? All the while pushing into that seam to get the mud right into that crack so it doesn't create a crack later on down the road. I'm keeping my joint knife right on the center, so I'm splitting the compound both this way and this way, and I'm gonna show you. We're gonna come back with a 10-inch taping knife right afterwards and feather this out a little bit. Just have to work it right into all those cracks everywhere. Cover that seam tape up. It's kind of fun. It's like being a kid. All right, so now that I've done that, I'm gonna go back with my 10-inch, okay? This is the 10-inch taping knife, and this is just going to spread the joint compound over the seam a little more. So we're gonna start over here. I'm just gonna lay it on that space right there. Again, I'm splitting right in the center, and I'm just gonna apply just a little bit of pressure, okay? I'm just gonna go right around that outlet. Just like that. And every time, you're just gonna go and clean it off in that mud pan. And that's the first coat. It's gonna probably take maybe two or three light coats to get this finished up. Afterwards, after it's all dry, we're gonna come back and with a block sander, a drywall block sander, which you can get at Home Depot or Lowe's, you're gonna come back and just lightly sand those edges off and feather that into the wall. One other thing I'd like to show you as well is we've got a 2-foot piece of sheetrock that we're attached here, but in some circumstances you've got a 4-foot sheet, you've got a 5-foot sheet. So what you want to do is, if you got a bigger sheet, you know, 4 foot or so, you're going to come up a third of the way. What I like to do is I'll put up the third away, one screw here, one screw there. I'll go up another third, you know, put two more screws. And then to get these guys, what you're going to do is just put a little bit of joint compound again on your tape knife. Just go ahead and press right in there and just lightly feather that right up. In this circumstance, we've got a joint right there, so. That will take care of that. These bottom screws, these are gonna end up being covered by the baseboard later on after the wall's all finished, so just go ahead and save yourself the time. All you need to do is mud up these screws that are in the center, mud up the seams that go horizontal, as well as any vertical seams, you're also going to tape, float, and mud. So with all the information that we've shared with you today, we hope that it can encourage you and empower you to get your home back to the way it was before.